Good evening, I'm Nicole Somavilla, and we are following breaking news tonight. It has been another difficult night of violence for the city of Syracuse and the police department. A shooting on the near west side has now left 9 people injured, one in critical condition. News Channel 9's Andrew Donovan is on the scene for us now. And Andrew, the mayor and police chief just wrapped up a briefing, and we know in some fashion there was a large gathering of, the police chief said, several hundred people tonight.
It was, but we'll do it again. This is the 11 o'clock news.
Nicole, sorry for the delay. We were just getting the mayor and police chief back over here. Chief Buckner, why don't we start with you? Just explain what you responded to. We're live on News Channel 9 right now. 9 people shot.
About 8:54 p.m. tonight, we responded to a stolen car report. While on scene, the officers encountered several hundred people that were running away from a scene, saying that there were shots being fired. Our officers did not hear shots fired while they were on scene. At some point, either through self-transport or through EMS from here, 9 different individuals were removed from here, taken to area hospitals. They are now all centrally located at Upstate Hospital, one of which is in critical condition. The remaining 8 are in stable condition with non-life-threatening injuries. We're in the early stages of our investigation, canvassing the area, attempting to collect as much evidence as we possibly can. There is no threat to the community at this time that we believe, and we have this scene here secure.
How much do you know about the event that was happening? I think in the parking lot right behind the WCNY building, right?
I do not know much about the event other than I believe this is the second or third year or so that it's been held. It was an event. Someone had something here. We will learn all of that as we get through our investigation.
What do we know about the possible suspects?
I don't know anything about the suspects at this time. We're within a few hours of this investigation. Obviously, we're trying to determine that. Again, we ask that anyone that may have information about that, if they will assist us by coming forward or get us information, that we'll be able to help with this investigation.
It's been a tough few months in the city. Which I'll ask the mayor about in a moment, but for you, for your officers, you know, police are more scrutinized now than ever. What's it like in that atmosphere to come do this and deal with such a crisis, really? 9 people shot.
Well, I would just remind people of a couple of things. The first is that some of the scrutiny that we have received has been valid, and we accept responsibility for that, and we responded in the form of a reform measure that the mayor took to let the community know how we're trying to turn the corner from that. But I think it has also highlighted what we ask police to do each and every day. I'm proud of our response here. This could have been a lot more catastrophic, but I'm certainly proud of our county, state, towns, and villages that also assisted us here on the scene.
All right, Chief, thank you. I'll let you sneak behind the mayor so I can bring Mayor Ben Walsh in. 9 people shot, but as you mentioned in your briefing a few minutes ago, knowing it was a party of hundreds, it could have been a lot worse.
It could have, yeah. I mean, we shouldn't be having parties like this right now. Not sure how it came about, but anytime you bring that many people together, especially under current circumstances, there's the likelihood of trouble. Again, could have been worse. So just thinking about the victims and the families, and very appreciative of our officers tonight.
Last week at a briefing, you said you're not sure it could get much worse, and now a shooting with 9 people, which is a lot worse. What do you do next to calm down the city, calm down people's anxiety? It's, you know, it's hard to be a member of society for everyone right now.
Yeah, these are trying times for sure. But again, every day we get up, we go to work, and I see amazing people in the city doing amazing things, taking care of each other, and we can't allow ourselves to be defined by the small group of individuals that are causing problems here. The tensions are high right now. We just have to make sure that we're taking care of each other. Again, my thoughts right now are with those victims and their families. Hopefully they will recover, and again, very appreciative of our officers tonight.
All right, Mayor Ben Walsh, thank you so much for joining us. Thank you. Mayor Ben Walsh and the chief of police updating us. 9 people shot here in the city's west side. And just to give you an idea of where I am, WCNY is right to my right here. That is not connected at all to the incident. the parking lot behind it, a large parking lot where we don't know exactly where, what business the parking lot is associated with. That's where the party is said to have been had. Hundreds of people, a few hundred is the term that the chief used, and then 9 people shot throughout that party. They don't know if the shooter or multiple shooters, that number is not known, if those people were part of the party or not connected to the party. So many questions still about what happened, but 9 people in the hospital, one of them in critical condition, the other 8 expected to survive, police continuing their investigation and desperate for help. Anyone that was at that party, anyone who knows anything, anyone in the surrounding area in the moments before, asked to call Syracuse police detectives as soon as possible as they look for surveillance video, interview people, and continue to figure out exactly what happened. Live in downtown Syracuse, Andrew Donovan, News Channel 9.